has messaged across our country and the world that jazz is an important cultural resource and a means of individual and community expression. And while jazz has its roots in African-American music and history, it has developed to include participants of all ethnicities and backgrounds. The Jazz Journalists Association recognizes a wide spectrum of musicians, journalists, authors, photographers, record companies, media, and jazz advocacy. You can go to Jazz Journalists Association to learn more about the great work that they're doing. Rita Riga can't remember a time when she was not passionate about jazz. She was 7 years old when she saw Louis Armstrong in the film High Society. And her first experience of live jazz was with the Charles Mingus Big Band in New York City, her hometown. In 1974, Rita Riga moved with her husband from New York to Seattle, where she landed at a commercial radio station that allowed her to play and program jazz and interview musicians on the air. With a third-class FCC license, she then joined a nascent board of directors, raising funds and helping to start a non-commercial station in Astoria, Oregon, even giving it its call letters, KMUN, and is still going strong today. She was a program director and on-air host for KKUL, a volunteer DJ on jazz station KMHD, and Rita currently hosts a bi-weekly jazz show, The World of Jazz, on Portland Community Radio, KBOO.FM. For 20 years, Rita wrote the column Musician of the Month for Jazz Scene, a Jazz Society of Oregon publication, served on their development committee, and now serves as their president. Since 2015, she has been the curator of the Cathedral Park Jazz Festival. This, my friends, is just an overview of her many accomplishments. So I will end with a quote from Rita when she was asked, "What do you think about jazz?" She said, "This music is life-affirming." So I'd like you to join me in saluting Portland, Oregon's jazz hero for 2022, Rita Riga.
Thank you so much, Marcia. Beautiful award. When I got the call, I was more surprised than anyone, okay? I knew about this Hero Award. I never thought I would be the recipient. And I really have to thank the Jazz Journalists Association, in particular the directors, like back east, Howard Mandel in Chicago and Susan Brink in New York. And of course, the Portland jazz journalists that nominated me, Lynn Derrick and Rick Mitchell. So thanks a lot, guys. All right.
Thank you so much. Enjoy the evening.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more round of applause for Rita Riga. Congratulations, Rita. Thank you, Marcia Hawker. Thank you to the Jazz Society of Oregon. It is now that time where I have just a couple words to say. I know nobody wanted to listen to me talk more, but too bad. I do think it's important to note that International Jazz Day, it brings a lot of questions about the origins of this music, and I think it's especially important to recognize the history of this neighborhood and the incredible diversity that made it what it is. And unfortunately, through consequences of gentrification, it's not nearly as rich in culture, but I do hope that what little we can do here with jazz music can keep that tradition alive. And I think it's important that we honor all the traditions that made this music possible, as Marcia referenced, but I think it's especially important to note that it is not one culture, but especially because of the traditions of the Black American music and indigenous peoples, we have this art that we get to listen to. So thank you, everybody, for making this music what it is. Love to welcome to the stage the incredible quintet you're about to hear. It features on piano George Colligan. On the bass, Mike Gurrola. On the trumpet, Joe Magnarelli. On the alto saxophone, Justin Robinson. And your band leader and drummer, the Willie Jones III. While they take the stage, I have a couple of questions to ask, a couple of favors to ask. If you could please keep your flashes off if you need to capture any moments for social media, which we think is super, do it. Also, if you could make sure your ringer is off, and if you could keep conversations to a minimum, as nobody needs to hear about your politics and religion while we're listening to this music. Save that for after. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. That was a Gary Bartz composition we played entitled Libra. And before that, we played an original composition of my own entitled Changing the Game. Right now we're going to feature Jill Magnarelli on a beautiful ballad entitled These Foolish Things.
Thank you. Thank you.
Let's give it up once again for Joe Magnarelli. All right, bringing Justin Robinson back up to the bandstand. We have one more tune to play for you for this set, this first set. I'd like to thank you guys so much for coming out to Club 1905. This is our first time playing here, and this is an incredible club. Portland represent. You guys have been an incredible audience, and we do have CDs for sale for those who still buy CDs.
Yeah.
Very cheap price, $10. So we're gonna finish things off for this set with a Buster Williams composition entitled Tokudo. No, I'm sorry, we played that already. Excuse me. We're gonna finish things off with Roy Hargrove composition, Public Eye. My apologies for that. Thank you guys so much for coming out. Public Eye. Thank you. Thank you guys so much. Once again, for Justin Robinson, alto saxophone. George Colligan on piano. Joe Magnarelli on trumpet and flugelhorn. Mike Gurrola on bass. Yours truly, Willie Jones III. Thank you guys so much for coming out. You guys have been a wonderful audience. We have one more show tonight. Thank you guys so much. Hope to see you guys soon. Thank you.